take it in, but don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Waiting on this for a while now, paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world.
I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. Don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Been waiting on this for a while now, paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Waiting on this for a while now, paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. And I know it's hard when you're falling down, and it's a long way up, and you make it round. But get up now, get up.
Hello, good afternoon to all of you out there. I hope you're having a lovely, lovely afternoon. We are here on the Unsaid show, and we're so excited that today we're going to talk about a topic that we personally also probably have gone through it quite a bit, still going through it, and it's going to be about body image. So today I have with me here, we'll start from the right.
All right, my name is Sara Al Maawali, and I'm excited for this topic.
Hi, I'm Tamsyn Pereira, and this is one of my favorite things to talk about.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sahar Salmanian, and I'm so excited for this topic. Call us, DM us. We would like to hear your ideas as well.
So basically, the Unsaid show talks about things that are mostly not talked about. And today, I think we are now in the season two. This is our second or third?
This is our second episode.
Second episode. We hope that you're following these episodes. They're on the YouTube channel of Oman FM. We're very excited that this is our new year. We finished last year, 2022, and we're starting on 2023 with all these topics. And one of the topics that people always ask us about, and as I said, we also have probably gone through it or read about it a lot or help with people with therapy with this, is body image. So if you want to talk to us about this, I'm going to give you, just in case, I'm going to give you two numbers, okay? So I'm going to give you 2494-9493. I'll repeat that, 2494-9493. And then there's another number that's 2464-0233. And we're waiting for your calls and your ideas. And also, they can do something else, right? They can DM us.
DM us on Not Alone page.
Yeah, and the more we hear from you, the more we can talk about it and the more we can discuss it. We're going to be using art, music, and also what movies talk about body image. So we start with that, actually, today. Let's flip it.
Yeah.
What movies talked a lot about body image?
There is this movie on Netflix. I just can't remember the name.
Mm-hmm.
But it was about this girl who was struggling with an eating disorder, actually. Yes. She was struggling with how she views herself. And then it led to an eating disorder.
Mm-hmm.
And she had to go to a house where there were a lot of people who were struggling with the same thing and get treatment.
Yes.
Do you guys
yes.
remember the name?
Yes. Did it have Ken Reeves in it or something?
I'm not sure. I don't remember.
Yes, I remember. She goes back to a house with people with different issues, but with obesity and also anorexia in the house or something like that. But yeah, tell us something about the percentage, Sahar.
The percentage. Researchers show that 56% of women are dissatisfied with their body image, and 43% of men are dissatisfied. So it's more between women.
Mm-hmm. And people probably think men don't even talk about this, which that's not
a close. I think it's very close. 56 to 43. Yeah. They are. It's really close.
And maybe sometimes they feel it, but they don't talk about it also, where maybe girls or women don't talk about it a bit more. Tam, you said this is one of the most important topics that you like talking about.
Yes.
So tell us a bit more about that.
I remember the one time we had a support group for anyone with body image issues in any age as well. And I was surprised at how many men showed up to that. I love that there's more men talking about mental health issues as well. And one of the men talked about body image issues, especially when they go to the gym, how so many men are expected to look a certain way and bulk up when that's not necessarily true. Or if a man is very skinny, they're body shamed for that and said that they're not man enough. Right.
They have to look buff, think of that,
right?
To be man enough, right?
Yes. I think.
Otherwise, they'll say, "Oh, you're so thin, and why aren't you built? And are you still?" Maybe they tell them, "Why are you still a boy? Aren't you a man?" I think that kind of comments, which are very difficult to hear.
Yeah.
Like look at the gyms as well. You'll see pictures of men and women who are so fit
on the wall.
But fit is not just one standard, right?
Yeah,
there's really big bulked up men, and there's all these supplements and protein powders that you have to look a certain way. And I keep bothering the gym people about how they need to change these posters.
You know, it's funny that you mentioned the gym, because I was at the gym a few days ago, and I looked at the posters. And as you said, they were all like skinny or like with abs, and also like this is like the same pictures you see everywhere.
Yeah, just one body type.
One body type.
I'm going to say the number again, sorry, before maybe somebody's trying to contact us. It's 2494-9493. So that's 2494-9493. If you're driving, please just stop the car. I know how it gets, where you want to memorize the number. I'm going to be saying it again and again, so don't worry about it. Yes, you're about to say something.
And it was very interesting. During COVID, there were some researches showing that online workout was a better element for people who are anxious to go to gym. Because when you go to gym, there are a group of people maybe
intimidated.
You know, then you compare yourself to them. If you feel like I'm not on a right journey, or I'm not very fast to be fit, so you feel anxious and you stop going to the gym. That's why you start gym, but after a while you feel like, no, I don't feel going. You find excuses not to go. So online workout and the YouTube channels and the online classes was something very good for people who feel insecure to go to gym and be in front of people.
I remember this funny story. We were at the in Greece, and we were going, you know, up on this hill where to go and see the the most important monument. I don't know what's happening in my brain now. I kind of forgot it. But anyhow, I was exhausted, and I hadn't even gone halfway. I was just like, oh my God. Because, you know, you don't do anything, then suddenly you think you're a sports person.
Yeah.
And I sat, and then after a little while, this lady who was way, way older than me just passed me, and she went zoom, going up. And I felt, what?
Embarrassed.
I'm going to push myself. So you do get intimidated with your peers or whoever is around you. So I can't imagine when people go to school, university, work, or within their family, you know, between their siblings, that they will feel the feeling of, I don't look good enough. I'm not pretty enough. I'm not handsome enough. My body doesn't look good. Look at other people. And people point it out sometimes. You know, they go, oh, look at your cousin. He looks better than you, or your sister, or your brother. Or did you see that person in your school? Look at you. You're not good enough. So that really affects people. And they don't, sometimes I think people don't notice how bad it could affect another person. They think it's just a comment, but it could actually affect them their whole life, and you don't even know that you've done that, which is very, very scary, actually.
So true.
I think it's really common in our culture and our society to compliment people, and they think it's a good compliment, but really it's not. Mm-hmm. For example, making a statement like, oh, you look like you've lost a lot of weight. Mm-hmm. You don't know if someone's going through an eating disorder or any sort of mental health issues. Mm-hmm. So I always say, you know, keep your compliments general, mm-hmm. generic, not body specific. Say, you look great today, or you have great energy today, mm-hmm. instead of saying something very specific about someone's weight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think they mean it sometimes in a good way.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes they think you're going to be really happy.
Yeah.
But sometimes they really exaggerate. I think Sahar was with me at an event when somebody said something. I was like, okay, very weird. But the way they were saying, they were like, what? So it sounded like something like, what? You've lost so much. I'm like, what? Was I, how big? I mean, it was a compliment.
Yeah.
But it kind of gave me so much, like, really? Is it this a compliment? Or did I look that bad?
Yeah.
So they're doing it sometimes in a good way.
Mm-hmm.
But the way they do it, and if you've gained, they're like, you've gained. If you've lost, they're like, you've lost. Mm. And you never win, actually.
Right.
You never
That's true.
Win.
No one's
if you
ever
lost,
satisfied.
Are you sick?
Yeah.
You've lost.
Yeah.
Are you sick? If you've gained, are you sick? So either way, there's something... not okay with how you
and I
are.
Guess yeah some people mean well, but I think it is important to be mindful.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is something we talk about with Tam about, and maybe people making comments, and I think it is important sometimes to call people out.
Yeah.
Especially if they hurt your feelings or what they said kind of bothered you, because if someone keeps saying the same thing over and over again, it's just going to get to you.
Yes.
And it's going to get to you really badly.
It's educating people how to treat us, because maybe you can handle it, but someone else can't speak up, and they, you know, feel it deeply.
It
affects their self-esteem, their, you know, functionality. So it's good to educate people in a very nice way that, thank you for your comment, but you know that makes me uncomfortable when you point out my body
it's
shape.
It's how you let that person know.
No one body shames you worse than family does.
That's
like
very true.
Going to visit older uncles and aunties and grandparents.
In a, for us, it's 8.
Yeah.
8 is a time
the
to
first
get
conversation.
Yeah. And so this time on my trip back home, I went to a wedding, and some random uncle who's not even related to me came up to me and said, first of all, this is an uncle I've met when I was a child, like maybe 4 or 5 years. So obviously I've grown. And the first comment he said was, oh, wow, Tamsyn, you got big, like really big. Ooh. And he made his hand like look sideways. And I said, well, thanks. I mean, you got kind of big too. I guess we're both eating really well. And he was too stunned to speak. But that was a boundary that I've learned to set after so many years of fighting against comments like this, right?
Yeah.
What do you all think? Have you all ever had to set a boundary?
Let's take a small break
and
give people also a chance to share with us their stories. And call us on 24949493. Don't change that dial, and we'll be back shortly.
This is Oman FM.
talked about is basically how others look at you.
Mm-hmm.
How do others look at you? Mm-hmm. How do others point out things? And I think Tam touched on a very, very important point. It's the people around you that's the most, that will probably, mm-hmm. Be hurtful. And I think sometimes your friends are hurtful without them knowing.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes they try and say it, but in a in a very try it sophisticated, but it sounds even worse. Mm-hmm. Like you'll be ready to go out. They'll be like, is that what you're going to wear?
Yeah.
And you're like, yeah. And then you become defensive. Sometimes they don't even mean it. You're like, why? That's not your best color.
I think people need to be taught how to compliment, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
How to compliment other people, how to be mindful, like you said, Sara, and how to make sure that your compliment isn't specific to your body, like I said before. Mm.
If you don't share it with them that this is not a good way to comment me, how would they know about it? So that's why it becomes part of the culture, because it's been repeated and no one is complaining, no one is stopping that, it's not a nice way to do so. And I think it's very important at a young age, when you are a child or a teenager and you're struggling to find out your identity, then all the criticisms and comments around you can have so much impact on the way you feel about yourself. I remember when I was a child, my mom has a very bright skin and my skin was darker. So, before I think it was a value, it was a beauty factor that you have a bright skin. So I remember all of my family members and our friends would say, Sahara, it's very nice that your mom is so pretty, but you're very different from your mom. Your skin is very different. You look cute, but your skin is different from your mom.
Like, what do you mean?
As a child.
I remember at that age, I felt so insecure about myself. I would do a lot of, cream powder just to make my skin brighter. And maybe they didn't know that how much they're affecting my self-esteem.
I don't think it's I think we've all probably gone through this film of color in different ways.
You're not dark enough, you're not light enough.
Why do you look so yellow today? Why you look so whatever? I think the funniest thing is when you already know that this is what's coming.
Mm.
So a lot of times, if personally I'll say, for example, I go, my granny's, she's Irish, they'll look at me and I'm like, I know what's going through their head. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah, and? They're like, no, we're just shocked. I'm like, why are you shocked? Because you have to look in their head, you have to look 1, 2, 3, 4.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't look that, so maybe you're making it up, But it doesn't have to be. Oh, and when you have someone come from a certain country and you tell them they come from this country and they go, are you sure? I'm like, why? Because they don't look... There's a certain stereotype in people's head. And I think our colleagues on the other shows talked about this before, which is a fantastic episode. I think it was Sayyida who talked about it. I think the way people perceive stuff, and we talk about racism, but we have within us all types of racism.
Yeah.
And maybe sometimes we don't call it the same, but it is the same.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the same.
And that's why when we say perception or perceptual is what we think other people think of us.
Yes.
It's their perception.
Yeah.
And I think sometimes when we hear the same comment more than once, it gets to us, right?
It gets to us.
Like, you look this way. And you don't hear it just from one person. You hear more than one person.
Then you believe it.
Then you start believing. It becomes a part of your perception, how you see yourself. Yeah.
Do you guys know the blue-eyed syndrome?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm, yes. Yeah.
Would you like to tell people out there? But I think people need to be educated about it.
Let me do this. Okay, go for it. Favorite thing to talk about, along with colonization and capitalism. I think that colorism and racism exist in every society and culture, right? We have to admit that it exists here as well. The blue-eyed syndrome is, we were talking about body images in the gym earlier and how you only mostly see very thin white people with blonde hair and blue eyes. I think we need to change our perception that the perfect beauty standard is a European beauty standard, right? We are all from different cultures and we need to accept that if our hair is curly or we're brown skin, that's because of our roots and it's something that we need to be proud of and not compare ourselves to a basic European standard of beauty.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone's beautiful in their own
way.
Exactly.
Right? Everyone. And that's a point we need to push as well. It's not like these are better than those. Also,
exactly.
We are all beautiful and God has made us different. That's the whole point. If we're yellow, if we're pink,
you know,
all these colors, and you know, it's colors.
Beauty colors is limitless. Are beautiful.
Exactly. So I think also, because sometimes also people go on the other side a bit too much. Also, I've noticed now. So now it's going the other way. Like now we're all angry and we're all into you know, colors. But why can't we all just accept each other, all of us? Mm-hmm. You know, always remember the Colors of Benetton. Do you remember? Mm-hmm. You know Benetton. I don't see it these days. Actually, that shop, United Colors of Benetton. I always think that's what we all are. All nations, all countries have a specific look, a specific color, a specific look. Hair, curly, straight, whatever it is, you're beautiful. And I think that's what we need to push. And yes, there is a lot of talk about colonization and, you know, all of these and color, but in the end, it's like we're doing the same thing,
right?
But now we're going on the other side. We just need to level it out and just accept each person how they are, because this is also another kind of things that's coming up that makes also no sense.
And I appreciate the small changes which are happening now. We see in fashion shows that we have like different, you know, different colors, different shape of bodies, which is very nice. Different skin colors,
different sizes.
Different sizes.
Which also in the fashion industry, the biggest problem they had was anorexic.
Right.
And as much as we see, wow, they're amazing and they're zero size, but they are going through a lot of psychological issues, which we don't, you know, we don't see. We look, oh, they look beautiful, you know, they're amazing, we want to be like them. But what do they do to stay like that? Actors, singers, you know, celebrities, public figures.
And they talk about it quite often, too.
All these people have to really work on themselves, and it's not easy. You know, it's I would say it's a personal war. You know, trying to keep yourself.
And I think there's more like body positive music out there now.
Yes.
Because there's a lot of body positive singers as well who want to advocate for that, because we, as we said, we have this one way of seeing people, and it's time to diversify that.
100%. One of our favorite things to do on the show is, because we're all from each different department, like the relationship department, the children's department, we always take whatever we're talking about and we look at it from a different perspective. So so Sahar, from the relationship department, what do you think, how does body image issues affect couples?
See, body image is a very fundamental feature in relationship, because at the end of the day, we are physical being. We experience everything with our body. We call it embodied experiences. We get sad, upset, happy, excited through our body. So we cannot remove our body, or we cannot just specify part of our body and just be focused on that, because it makes us being very self-conscious. And when we are so self-conscious about our body, then we cannot leave the moment. This is something we need a lot in our relationship. When in the beginning of relationships, when we are dating someone, we don't know anything about each other, and we might feel like this, that our appearance is the most important thing that we have to present, although research has shown that it's not like that. The feeling, the vibe that we are sending to that person that we are meeting is more important than our appearance. They can feel your security or your insecurity, the way you feel about yourself, more than the way you look. This is one thing in dating part. And then for sexual activities and sexual relationship, it's really important, because in sexual activity, we need to be in the moment and we need to be focused and mindful more than any other times. And if you're so focused on your body, how you look, then you cannot perform very well. And then you cannot receive the messages your partner is sending you. That's why the more you love yourself, the better you can send love to your partner.
Yeah, and communicate. I love that. Communication. What about the children department?
Children's department. So I see a lot of clients that do struggle with their body image. And I think, Tamsyn, you can agree with that.
Yeah.
And because it's so common, I think also social media plays a role. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of the clients that I hear usually say it started in 2020. Mm. You know, usually when during COVID, you're sitting by yourself, you have a lot of time to analyze your body, analyze how you look, looking and lurking in social media, looking at other celebrities.
I think we need to also give people the number. So this is a really important topic for them to call us in.
So,
I'm just going to say quickly, and while Sara continues, is 24949493. 24949493. Yes, Sara.
So, like, as I said, in social media plays a huge role. And also, again, as we said earlier, the comments you get, it starts playing in your mind. You start hearing the same voices you used to hear maybe in childhood or as growing up, and then it starts getting to you.
Nice. Yeah. Let's hold that thought and let's go for a short break and come back and continue about the social media part.
All right.
This is Oman FM.
If I was you, I'd want to be me too.
Too.
Same.
That sounds relatable. A bit like our last episode. If you guys haven't watched our last episode, go and watch it and you'll understand why we think that song has to do with our last episode. So, social media.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm. So obviously, from the children's department, Sara and I always discuss how so many kids resist asking or setting boundaries. Because they say, oh, if I set a boundary with this uncle or auntie or grandparent, it's rude, right? What do you think of that?
Yeah, I get that quite often. Or they're kind of scared of maybe getting like a backlash or maybe being scolded or embarrassed by that person.
But it's true. Yeah. I mean, you will sound rude. Yeah. Whatever you do, you will sound rude. Mm-hmm. Even in our culture, even at this age, if you say something, you might sound, you know, off. So you have to be very careful. But maybe for kids, they need to tell their parents. It's their parents' job to defend them.
So my piece of advice, whenever a kid asks me a question like that, if they say, oh, I can't set a boundary like that with my uncle or aunt who body shames me, because it's rude. And I always say, okay, maybe instead of saying, hey, I don't like when you say that, maybe tell them how you feel. So say, hey, when you comment on my body or you say, oh, you've lost weight or you've gained weight, it makes me feel embarrassed or conscious and I don't really like that very much. And maybe that way bringing empathy into the picture would help them see what it's like to be in your shoes.
And yeah. something I also tell my clients, that regardless of the response you get, sometimes yeah. it can be out of defense or embarrassment. Mm-hmm. Just, it's important that you did your part. Yeah. You defended yourself, regardless of the outcome, regardless of what they say. Mm-hmm. It's important that you said your part.
But I think also they have to see what type of uncle is this and what type of auntie. You have to study.
Be smart about it.
Yeah, and I think also if they do it, they need to go straight and tell their parents. Both ways, mm-hmm. tell your parents.
Yeah.
And maybe your parents will be like, well, that's your auntie or that's your uncle, but tell them.
At least they know.
At least they know. Yeah. If you go before, you tell, before you want to say that, or after, inform your parents. And I think parents, I think we need to talk to them as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, first of all, you as a parent, try not to do that to your child. I know, as a parent, I know we want our kids to be the best. Mm-hmm. I know, I totally understand that. But we need to understand also, what are they going through? How they're going through it? I mean, I can see a parent go and fall into this, you know, hole without wanting to. Mm-hmm. I can totally see
without
that.
Without intending
exactly.
to.
So maybe we just, if we did that and we didn't mean to, we need to tell our child why we said that and we apologize if it hurt them.
Yeah.
It has to start from home.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because if the parent is doing this, then the aunt and uncle and all of that, the whole family is the same. You know, that kind of thing. Mm. So it has to start from home. And we need to not put our insecurities into our children because that's what happens.
Projection is when they're projecting their own.
Yeah, maybe we went through something. Let's say if somebody was a bit overweight or whatever, and they think they went through, you know, trauma. Mm. They don't want their kids to go. So then they stop their kids from eating stuff. They stop their kids from enjoying life. They're always aware. And that puts a lot of stress. Mm-hmm. That's the worst you can do to your children, actually.
And also dieting at a very
early age. And we see that a lot. We see that a lot.
Because dieting at an early age for a child can lead to an eating disorder.
Mm. Definitely.
Or a bulimia.
Yeah, sometimes they do it if children eat a lot of, worried about diabetes. Mm-hmm. And I see this. But then where do they get all these sweets and stuff? Mm-hmm. Isn't there at home?
Yeah.
So then your whole household needs some kind of, you know,
change. I think you can make it fun.
Yes.
Like a day where we all eat vegetables.
Exactly.
Or a day where
the whole family
as a whole. And rather than, okay, you have to eat this on your own while we're eating all the regular food.
Exactly. And plus, I think we've seen that a lot, right, in families.
Right.
Where suddenly we see you know, somebody in the family really strict with their children when it comes to food. Mm-hmm. And then that child comes to your home and like, auntie, can I eat this? Because at home we're not allowed to eat this.
Exactly.
And you're like, eat it. And then the mom finds out, you're like, busted.
That's why we always say parents should work on themselves first and to, you know, get along with their own insecurities, because kids are so wise and they copy you. Plus, how you treat your kids, be careful about how you are, you know, focused on your body and how couples, partners, commenting each other. Because we have seen in families, I'm sure Tam and Sara are dealing with that also, that couples, parents, body shame each other in front of the kids. And they learn that at home. But if they see that one of my parents are chubby, but they love their body as it is, they learn to love themselves as well. So I think it's more than just the verbal behavior. It could be even the dynamic that you have in your family, your household, and you teach your kid by your behavior, the way you treat each other as couples and parents.
Yes. I think it's not always the negative aspect, like saying, oh, you've put on too much weight or too less weight sometimes. I have a theory, okay, and I'm only basing this on, based on clients that I've seen with body image issues who didn't realize they have body image issues, but then I've seen the mother in the session as well. And this has happened quite a few times where a mom would take extreme care of herself, like monthly pedicures, manicures, hair appointments, and then I'd see the same behavior in the child as well. And sometimes it's as young as like 4 or 5 years old. It's heartbreaking to see a 4-year-old child come to me for a session saying, oh, I wish my hair was straight and I wish my skin was white, you know? And this was something that I had worked on this child for months and months together, only for Eid to come and the mom straightened her hair. And so I was like, this goes against everything we learned about how all shape, sizes, hair texture, anything is fine, you know.
Yeah, but there's nothing wrong with that, Tam. I want to just, because I think also we need to be mindful with that part. Mm-hmm. That, oh, but they want to be, you know, maybe it's, you can teach the child that you can have this and this.
Mm-hmm. Right, right. It's that not, part oh, was absent.
It's not, this means it's something not you. Maybe they want, it's okay, it's a mood. But also we need to get the kids to understand two worlds is fine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
We cannot keep on jumping only on one, like we're a group and they're I agree.
It was only because this child had constantly said I'm not beautiful and like saying really dismissive things to themselves.
Whatever they do, that kind of
so word. That was absent. I think so mothers and daughters, I think that's the like the strongest relationship for body image issues that needs to be worked on as well.
Very much
so true. What do you think about fathers and sons?
It's the same.
Yeah.
The same. They have the same issue. Exactly. But again, maybe men don't show it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not like how women usually show stuff. So. Mm-hmm. But in the end, it's the same thing. Oh, my dad, look at him. He's strong. He looks good. Look how he dresses. You know, that kind of thing. So it's not only to do with girls, but boys don't show it.
Mm-hmm.
And when they do, society goes, wait a minute. You're a boy, mm-hmm. you know, that kind of, which is not right.
Yeah.
And I think one of the series that I really, it was a hard series to watch, but it was very educational, I think, was 10 Things I Hate About You. It's not 10 Things, that's the movie. The series about the tapes.
13 Reasons Why.
13 Reasons Why, my God, that 10 is totally another, sorry guys, I got all my films messed up. But that one had so many things issues. In the show, mm-hmm. so many issues, and every teenage movie or series talks about anorexic and body image and bulimia. Have
even
you noticed?
In Ginny and Georgia as well, there was
one of the friends.
Yeah,
actually,
one of the friends was struggling with
and
her
she
body.
Totally fine.
Yeah.
So every movie.
The famous cartoon on Shirley. Remember that she had red hair on Shirley. It was a very, like, very old cartoon, and it was all about her, because everyone was, their hair was black or blonde, but her hair was red.
Yes, and also that's something else, that people have issues with redheads.
Yeah.
So you see, like, they go, oh, they're redhead, or they're ginger, you know, that,
they
again,
call them
within the same, so that's why the thing about body image is, we need to accept every type and every look and whatever makes you feel good.
Yeah.
Whatever you choose.
And you know, something I hear quite often is, if I, let's say, lose more weight, I'll be more happier with myself.
Yes.
Or if I change my nose, if I change my eyes, if I change my hair, I'll be more happier. And something I would tell my clients is that, okay, if you do that, then what will you be? How sure are you that you're going to be that happy?
Mm-hmm.
Will anything change?
Mm-hmm.
And I think something that we incorporate in our sessions is accepting. First is accepting.
100%.
And then working on other things. Yeah. Just accepting your body, accepting the way you are. Even if, like, for example, if you want to work on becoming more fit,
mm-hmm.
how about you love your body as it is
and
then
is it
working
to be
towards
healthy as well? Or is it only doing good? Is it two in one? That kind of thing.
Yeah.
Let's go for a short break.
All right.
This is Oman FM.
What's deeper than the darkest best? Kept secret beneath the surface, we kid. Let it bring us together, or it could tear us apart. Oh, I'm filled with it. I got a love with no conditions. Though it's hard to re-envision time and time again. Even when.
And we're back. And if you want to call us, it's 24949493. So it's 24949493. This topic definitely needs another episode.
Yeah.
It's very
episode two.
Huge and big, and there's so many streams.
So many different aspects
and
of body.
Yeah, I got a DM actually, and the DM is about a girl who's getting ready to get married.
Mm.
A new life, and she's really worried about how she will look because her in-laws are all, what she says, they're all beautiful and slim and all of that, and she's worried that she probably won't fit in to this unique and beautiful family.
I know, I know.
It's
That's
tough.
A huge problem.
It's tough.
And we normally see that when you're getting married, you know, you want to be the best version of yourself, but unfortunately you are not sure if that version is based on your choice or what others are telling you. We have two views for body image, and I wanted to share it with you. It's the first one is individualistic view. It's the way you see your body, and the other one is the collectivist view, the way your body should be. And when we go to this second one, we tend to see what are the norms, what are the standards, and we try to adjust ourselves to those standards. Let's say for this DM, you go to a new family and you try to find out what is beauty in their family, and then you try to adjust yourself to those standards. But the issue is here, how long can you follow others' standards? Maybe later on you go to work after getting married, you go to work, and in your workplace their standards is different. Are you going to change yourself again? And you never find yourself satisfied of your body, because those standards are based on their own values in different backgrounds, and they are constantly changing. So I think that individualistic view can help us a lot to see ourselves the way we are. And it's fun if we want to change ourselves, if we want to change our the way we look, our appearance, the way we dress up, but based on our own choices.
And maybe it's something that would be useful as well, is that the person that she's getting married, think about it, your partner chose you. And of course, going into a family can be tough, can be like, as you said, Sahar, like different perceptions of what the family views you as. But your partner chose you for who you are, for your individuality. And I think just remembering that, that he is marrying you.
Yeah. And that they should be a team. I mean, he should have her back.
Exactly.
And she should have his, you know. That's the only way that this boat will basically sail nicely. Because things do happen, and people do throw comments that are really bad. And especially if you have a sister-in-law that looks maybe in there, you know, maybe in education, maybe in family, and
in
looks.
Aspects.
It's not just looks. So you have to be basically, in the end, I think it's got to do with self-esteem as well. This is to do with you more than anything. So the person who sent the DM is to do with you mostly. Just build that self-esteem as much as you can, and I'm sure you're gonna, you know, you're gonna be fine, and everything's gonna be beautiful, and you're gonna be a beautiful, beautiful
And I really liked what you said, not everyone is gonna like us. You get married and maybe your in-laws don't like you. That's not, you know, necessary. As long as you are a team with your partner, and you know why your partner chose you, I think that's enough for your relationship.
And you go into marriage wanting to be, you know,
wanting
the
to be
loved one. Everyone.
Especially your mother-in-law and your mother, like, I want to be the best, and becomes like, but how much can you do? In art, because we always talk about the art piece, and I think the art piece that I found, which I'm going to show you ladies, and then we'll tell the people about it. It's basically a body, but this is a part of the body, which is quite interesting.
Okay.
And there's another one that's to do with a body that has all these words on them. And then we have this one. So the art that I'm showing them is basically a body that has a big rope around the tummy, really, really tight. I think to do that small, small waist. And the other picture basically was a body with lots of comments in it, from your head to your toe. And it just shows you how people can attack you and attack every part of your body, and how in mental health, each part of your body actually gets hurt. You know what film comes to mind all the time with these things? Shallow Hal.
I don't think I've seen that.
I haven't watched.
It's a very, it's not new at all. And it's about this girl who thinks she's No.
Oh, the guy.
The person, the guy sees her.
Yeah, he hits his head or something. Yeah. And then he sees this woman who is overweight, but he sees her as very thin.
Really
and,
good.
And yeah, he forms
a he's a fussy person, actually.
Yeah, and then he forms a bond with her and then doesn't recognize her. And I don't know, he hits his head again and then comes back to reality.
But in the whole show, the whole movie, it shows us in the beginning how he's very picky. With who he wants to go out with who he's really, really picky.
Shallow.
He's a shallow person. Shallow. And then when he this happens, he sees her. And everybody sees her, the real her. And he doesn't see it.
Yeah.
And that's it's very interesting. And there's another movie also of this, the girl who goes to the gym. Mm-hmm. She's a comedian.
And she hits her head.
And she hits her head. She's so pretty, I think it's called. She's so pretty.
Yeah, she's so pretty.
Yes, and she hits her head and then she thinks... And this film is literally about confidence and body image. So she thinks she's really amazing and she succeeds in work and everything. And then suddenly, I guess in the end, again, she wakes up to find out she isn't that kind of thing.
So for any of us who don't hit her,
people are going to hit their heads today. Like they told us to hit our heads.
How do you think we can self-validate our own thoughts without hitting our heads? What do you think?
I think, as you mentioned earlier, setting boundary is really important. And setting boundary after realizing that what are your values? What are the things, even the bare minimum, that you like about yourself? Yeah. I remember myself when I was at that age and I was so insecure about my skin color. Mm. I started going to Taekwondo classes. Mm-hmm. And at that moment, when I started the physical activity, I started making peace with my body. So that could be a very good solution to try to use your body in a good way, that you feel proud of your body, your bodily function, not only the appearance, what I can do with my body, not only the how my body looks.
So that's really, really good.
What about
point.
You, Sayyida Basma?
I think also the same. I think you have to build your self-confidence because people are going to try and say things to you. They always, continuously, throughout your life.
Yeah. Yeah.
Even when you're with someone, they could tell you, oh, look, she's pretty, not look at us. And you could say, I'm sorry, look at you, I'm fine. You know, that kind of thing. Just hit it at the same time. And don't be part of that group that feels they're always, you know, in Arabic we go, masakin, you know, the actually fight back and do it continuously. The more you do it, the more stronger you get. And just have confidence in yourself. I think confidence, I always say confidence is a superpower. And it helps you through everything. But as a parent, you need to help your child to build their confidence. And you will feel that's what you should be proud about. Not about only how they look, about how they fight back and how they deal with things.
Yeah,
I think for me, I would say if there's something you don't like about your body, find another part of your body that you do like and find safety in it. And then starting to learn and to love parts of yourself gradually. If there's something you don't like if you don't like your arms, is there another part of your body that you do like? It can be your heart, your organ, your arm, your brain. Yeah. It can be your bones that help you, you know, to lift things, to walk. So to find a part of your body that you do like and find safety in. Or it can be even just a personality. It doesn't have to be, because your body doesn't have to be everything about you.
Exactly.
You are more than just your body.
Yeah.
Second thing is to start following more body positive individuals and people.
Definitely.
I think that would be a changer.
Is
to start following people that love their body and that are not perfectionist and they're just, you know, enjoying themselves and accepting themselves.
Yeah.
You will start immediately also replicating.
And
that.
Balanced people who talk sense.
Who talk sense.
They're not on one side and not on the other side.
So
it's
maybe start
important.
Looking into who are you following?
And who's your friends and your peers?
Yeah, that's a very, you know, important key to do a detoxing. Constantly detox your social media, detox the friend
social
groups that you have around you.
Yeah.
If something is making you uncomfortable, that's your choice to unfollow them or to, you know, set certain boundaries.
And it doesn't mean some people go, oh, but she has the brain, so that's fine. No. You can have all, both.
Yeah.
It depends on how you see yourself.
Right.
Some people go, oh, but she has this, that's why she, oh, God gave her this maskina, but he didn't give her this. God gave us everything. You work with everything. Tam, what do you think?
My piece of advice, something that I tell all clients, is that if you are working on a body image issue, and through therapy, you know, we work through deep-rooted issues of why you have that thought in the first place, while you're working on that, and that's a lot of hard work, while you're working on that, if you are going to do a diet or you're going to work out or anything, do it the right way. Go see a nutritionist. 100%. Do it the safe way so that you're not, and you don't end up self-harming, you know? Mm-hmm. There's a lot of different ways you can self-harm. So don't end up doing it the harmful way. Do it in a safe way while you work on an underlying issue, the root cause issue of why you feel like that.
And we had an exciting show. Thank you all out there. And just remember, you are beautiful, all of you, in every single way. And that one, two, three.
Change begins with you.
Thank you. Have a blessed
Bye-bye.
Day.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
This is Oman FM.